Hi, my name is Michael Le Havre. I'm the Executive Vice President for PFIG Group.
My name is Wolfgang Helms. I'm an engineer, PFIG Group.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. My name is Yakub Suleiman from Raw Material Research and Development Council.
Okay, thank you very much. I think no one is left out. Okay, the next row, please.
My name is Engineer Abdullahi Arso, from the Ministry of Solid Minerals Development.
Mr. Chairman.
The Chairman and honorable members, Ime is my name, Ime Ekripo, from Solid Minerals Ministry.
Mr. Chairman and honorable members, my name is Obong Amaide Ntuk, JP. I represent Ikotabasi community.
Mr. Chairman, sir, my name is Eno Winifred Akpaka, the President, Coalition of Ikotabasi Nkwaren in Eastern Obodo, the host community. Thank you, sir.
Good morning. So, therefore, you're welcome in view of some reasons that you mentioned. I say, well, the decision of the how that you must be here. So we'll start with you so that you will have an excuse maybe to leave your legal team to continue in case what you want to attend outside the house is an urgent matter. So first of all, I will ask the staff of the committee to administer the oath so that you can give your statement entirely based on the non-implementation of the decision of the Supreme Court regarding these issues.
I am not a legal practitioner, but the oath has to be taken that all the evidence that you're going to give before this honorable gathering shall be the truth and nothing but the truth. Amen.
Commercialization. The Supreme Court judgment on ALSCON, as it affects the BPE guided transaction, was done several years back. But basically, sir, we have a submission, which I'm sure has been distributed. I also apologize that it is coming a bit late, because we needed to be sure the information we are bringing before the Honorable Committee. Very quickly, sir, I will probably just speak to the report. I don't want to take you through the letters. The content speaks for itself, and I'm confident that it explains the transaction from commencement to finish. However, by the time the Supreme Court judgment came out, you see that on page 2, specifically stated that an order of specific performance is decreed directing defendant BPE to provide mutually agreed share purchase agreement for execution by the parties to enable the plaintiff BFIG Group pay 10% of the accepted bid price. And the accepted bid price was $410 million within 15 days from the date of the execution of the SPA in accordance with the agreement dated 2004. Thereafter, 90% of the $410 million is to be paid within 90 days. Then the second order of the Supreme Court was that the defendant respondent should accept payment, that is BPE, should accept payment of the 10% of the bid price from the appellant within 15 days from the date of signing the SPA. And then three, an order of perpetual injunction restraining the defendant servant's agent's previous management or howsoever called from inviting any further bidding for the sale and acquisition. So I can of ALSCON in violation of the contract between the plaintiff and. So speaking to that, I can tell you definitely that we have not invited any further bidding on ALSCON. So order three has been substantially complied with in line with the Supreme Court judgment. Then in respect of one and two, if you go to page three, just a minute, let me see if I can bridge this. He was reinstated as the preferred bidder. You see that as number 3.1. BPE forwarded to BFIG a copy of the draft SPA, share purchase agreement, so that they can comply with the provisions of the court, the Supreme Court order. Rather than executing the SPA, the draft as sent, BFIG drafted their own SPA, their own share purchase agreement, and forwarded same to BPA. And they rewrote the consideration, which is the $410 million. They actually provided $250 million as the consideration they intend to pay. But the Supreme Court judgment affirmed that the terms of the contract was to be governed by the submissions earlier made. The winning bid was $410 million. So these matters were referred to the legal committee of NCP. You see that on page 4, 3.4. And the committee rejected the draft SPA sent by BFIG for the following reasons: that the letters and tenor of the Supreme Court judgment clearly suggested that the fundamental terms of the SPA to be executed between the parties was the one agreed in 2004. So it was not meant to draw up a new agreement. The terms and conditions were actually affirmed in the Supreme Court judgment. Two, that the draft prepared and presented by BFIG appeared to be a boilerplate used in developing the earlier SPA in 2006 and went beyond that to create new terms without any basis. And those new terms were not within the contemplation of the Supreme Court judgment. C, the new terms introduced in the SPA prepared and presented by BFI constitute a renegotiation. The Supreme Court did not say we should renegotiate. And then the most telling examples, among others, is that whereas the Supreme Court clearly held that ALSCON had been sold to BFIG for $410 million, BFIG in their own draft reduced the sale price to $250 million. Page 5. The Supreme Court judgment did not set any deadline for the execution of the judgment, which begins with the signing or execution of the SPA. The clause in the judgment specifying timelines and deadlines for payment of the 10% first and 90% second of the purchase consideration should be considered strict and non-negotiable. And we actually forwarded the SPA in line with the 2004 conditions, terms and conditions, and then the date started running, the timeline started running as soon as we sent that. And then F, in accordance with the agreement reached at the Technical Bid Conference 2004 and other agreements of record, all of which the Supreme Court upheld to be binding on both parties, BFIG has to procure a fresh bid bond in the amount of $1 million from a first-class bank as a condition precedent to executing the prospective SPA. That was part of the contract terms. Consequently, BPE sent an offer letter to BFIG to execute the SPA, which complies with the order of the Supreme Court, within a period of 6 weeks, make payment of the purchase consideration within the timelines earlier specified by the Supreme Court, 15 days and 90 days. And submit a business plan as required in the SPA. BFIG refused to execute the SPA that was prepared, in compliance with the judgment. It also insisted on the SPA which they prepared and which was at variance with the copies that were sent to them. And let me mention here that the SPA forwarded by the BPE was the trigger for the time to start running in line with the Supreme Court judgment. It's when that SPA is received by them, the first 15 days will start to count after they execute. Now they did not execute. And then they sent an alternate. The alternate now was meant to reopen a negotiation which the Supreme Court didn't ask us to do. The transaction for the co-investor sale of ALSCON to BFIG was terminated after the expiration of the deadline of March 2013, given to BFIG to sign the SPA and pay 10%. None of this was done, payments not made. Subsequent to that, BFIG went back to Supreme Court to give meaning to the intendment of the judgment or the ruling of the Supreme Court of 6 July 2012, particularly the phrase mutually agreed share purchase agreement. In 2016, as a result of the Supreme Court ruled that in consequence that BFIG is deemed to have forfeited its rights. No, I'm sorry, please. BFIG filed an action at the Supreme Court to challenge the decision of BPE to terminate the transaction and also asked the court to give meaning to the judgment of the Supreme Court dated 2012, particularly the phrase mutually agreed share purchase agreement. In 2016, the Supreme Court ruled that in consequence that BFIG is deemed to have forfeited please delete 4.2. Delete 4.2. 5.1. In 2013, BFIG instituted suit number FHC 901-2013 at the Federal High Court in Abuja, seeking the interpretation of the Supreme Court judgment. And Justice Abdul Kafarati delivered judgment on 30th September 2014 in favor of BFIG. Dissatisfied with the judgment, BPE appealed, and Dissing Holdings Limited, the co-investor in ALSCON, applied to be joined as an interested party. I think the point we're trying to make earlier was that when the timeline ran out and the NCP closed out on BFIG, they actually went back to the Supreme Court, and the Supreme Court just a minute, sir. The Supreme Court actually advised that his judgment was clear and that there was no ambiguity in the judgment. So they declined to make any take any further action in respect of the request by BFIG. So thereafter, they went to the High Court. They went back to the High Court and then obtained judgment against BPE. And then BPE appealed. So as we speak, the matter is in the appeal court. Page 7. In 2014, Dessin Holdings Limited instituted another suit in Uyo. The plaintiff sought an order of perpetual injunction restraining the BPE's agents or any person from claiming through or deriving authority from it or otherwise howsoever from disturbing Dessin Holdings' 77.5% shares in ALSCON. A series of other actions were also filed by them. On page 8, distinguished members of the House Committee wish to bring to your attention that from the beginning of this transaction, the inability of BFIG to meet the conditions and terms of the contract they bidded for has been the reason for this protraction from the beginning, even before the Supreme Court judgment. So, with the Supreme Court judgment, we honored the judgment by taking steps and issuing the necessary documentations to BFIG. But the responses were not in line with the Supreme Court judgment. And so we could not be seen to be honoring the judgment in the breach. So, and that is why the matter at the moment is still sub judice. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, your mic. Thank you very much, and you all had his statement regarding this issue. And if you ask, you may take leave if you want to at the moment. So I will next go to the, except if the honourable members have some questions to ask. Okay. So then I will ask the, your side. Of, yeah, so now it's your side now to hand off.
Just a quick one, sir. I don't know if I could be excused, but I'll leave the head of legal behind. Thank you so much, sir. I appreciate it.
Are you, let's go to page six.
No, not this.
Page six, just before you leave, I want to confirm that you are reinstating 4.2 from your last statement. Okay. Okay, thank you. The facts. As it. Okay.
They went back to the Supreme Court.
Okay.
And the Supreme Court stated that their ruling and their orders were very clear and that parties should run by that. So they declined any further documentation of the party. Thank you, sir.
Have complied with all requirements of the Supreme Court judgment. And I have documented our response and made it available to the members of the committee. And all the information pertaining to this matter is in here, and we have additional information in the event the committee would like to see them. But specifically, before the DG departs, I would like to call your attention to the last page, which is a letter that was written to the chairman of National Council on Privatization by Chief Wole Olanipeku, SAN, and Patrick Ikweto, SAN, that described the whole transaction, and particularly what happened at the Supreme Court the second time. I'm saying this to clarify the point that when the FIG group went to the Supreme Court wondered why this transaction could not be closed because they have issued an order and decree asking them to give us a mutually agreed share purchase agreement and also reinstate us with a perpetual injunction. They reinstated us by giving us a letter pursuant to the judgment, and they followed it with a 58-page share purchase agreement. And this 58-page share purchase agreement was given to us by the chief legal counsel of BPE. And it was transmitted to us via email. We acknowledged it on October 8. After the acknowledgement on October 8,
we requested for additional information because that share purchase agreement that was given to us contained a price of 250. 250 was not in anywhere at all implanted there by BFIG. And I repeat again, the chief legal counsel of BPE transmitted that 58-page mutually agreed share purchase agreement and asked us to execute that. Now they put in 250. We accepted it, asked our counsel in the United States to review it, and discuss with the DG then, which is Dr. Onagorua, and then return it back to them on October 23. Then BPE decided, waited for a while, and I asked them, what is the problem? And they said, none. And BPE formally acknowledged that 58 page with 250 million on November 22nd. And even pleaded with us that we should not please be upset because they have other things that they're doing, that everything is going well. All that is needed now is for us to go and inspect the plant, because we complained about the condition of the plant after 10 years. That letter is also furnished to the committee. I will say, yes. Okay. This is the only copy I have left. I think I've given them.
I don't have a copy here.
Okay. Yes.
They need to have a copy. In case you have any
problem. I think it's about, I'm sorry, we did not mark them. It's about 7 or 9 pages. Yeah.
About 15, 16.
Yes. It's a letter dated November 22nd. Just here. At the early introduction of it. November 22. November 22 is after.
Found the pages.
I think we need to draw the SPD.
Yes. This
250 you're talking about, is it in the SSPA or the data?
No, it's in the SPA that the BPE sent to us.
The first, that's it.
That's correct.
Because I have 410 in that SSPA.
Exhibit
A. Second.
That they sent to us.
So are you enjoying this document or are you standing by this document?
Brad, I will take a look at that, please. Maybe, let me see.
This is your document. This page four of the Exhibit F.
This is the second SPA.
Page 4 of the SBA.
Is that not the second SBA?
Second contract.
Yes. Exhibit F is the exhibit that was enforced by Judge Kafarat.
Where's the email? The email they sent.
What happened in the past. I think the actual purchase price
of 250. Yeah, it's yeah, it's got, let me show you. Wait. That particular SPA that is here, I believe, okay, I'm sorry. Look at page 11, page 13. Page 13. 13, 1, 3. The purchase price was 250 million. Page 13. Page 13, Mr. Chairman.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
That's correct. So that is exactly what was mailed to BFIG Group on October 8, pursuant, October 8, 2012, pursuant to Supreme Court judgment after they reinstated us. We received it, it was a total of 58 pages. Purchase price offered to us was 250. We now looked at it and we called them, we discussed, and few changes were made. And one of the changes that was made was, one, a request for all the exhibits. And the exhibit was about 3,000 pages of document, which BPE again forwarded to us in a binded this thing and delivered it to us on, I believe, sometime October 18. Then our counsel in the US reviewed all, and we now agreed to accept it. And we emailed that back to them. We signed it and returned it back to them. Then on November of 2012, the 22nd, they sent us a letter affirming the receipt of that and telling us that, and that letter was signed by Mr. Omotowa, Ruben Omotowa.
Please.
I'm sorry, please, I didn't number the page, but it's about 10 pages from the beginning. Yes. It's signed by the Director General, Acting Director General, R.G. Omotowa. It's right here, just a few pages after this. Okay. Dated November 22nd. Uh-huh. And that letter gave all our investors a rest of mind, full assurance, because they again accepted the 58 page and told us that all is well. We are just waiting for an inspection of ALSCON because we raised concern as to the technical condition of the plant. This was taken to NCP. And then NCP in that November issued a letter asking them to take us to ALSCON and asking BFIG to be a member to inspect the property. So we did all that, except that the Russians challenged the BPE that we cannot come in. So, and then they wrote BPE, and let me read what the letter that they wrote, I mean, they said. They said that, Your Excellency, the letter was dated on the 20 July of 2012, the same month that we got the judgment.
Do you have a copy?
Yes, it's in here too.
The fence copy, or you have a clear copy?
I don't have. This was given to me by the VPE themselves, and it was fent when I got it, yes. And the letter titled Russians demanded several things from them.
You were given the PPE directives.
Directives. That's correct. That BPE will not make any steps to enforce the judgment in any manner whatsoever. Supreme Court. That was number one. Number two, that BPE will not allow BFIG Group to enforce the judgment in any manner whatsoever. Number three, that BPE will prevent, people will preserve Dayton from suffering any loss in any way of enforcement of the judgment. Number four, that BPE will protect Dayton from any action that we may bring on them. In fact, all this up to the 8 commandments that they issued to them. And this came on July of 2012, even when we were still trying to make sure that we comply with the Supreme Court judgment. And today, what BPE have done so far has been the implementation of these directives given to BPE by UC Rosal, and that they should frustrate this judgment from the word go. And I'm sure a clean copy of this.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
I have a question.
Yes.
Are you saying the BPE?
Why? By the conduct of BPE today, which is contained in their own memo, obviously, that is what I will conclude. Because the judgment came up, was delivered July 6th by the Supreme Court. July 19th, this letter was written to them, and I'm sure the DGBP can provide the committee with a clean copy of this memo.
Clean copy of this
claim. I can give you a copy.
Which
page? Yes.
What page?
Unfortunately, we did not number this.
Okay.
That was for the court. Yes. I'm sorry we could have. Yeah. Have you seen it?
Okay. It's a letter from Dyson Holdings Limited.
Okay.
Letter from
page 14.
No,
I've seen the letter.
It's from you?
Yes,
from
us.
Okay.
From you. We speak to Dr. Yes, from us.
Okay.
What page is it? There's no, what is the, it's page 3, but I thought the word page the document.
Yes. Yeah, we're paging it now, okay. Council.
I'm
yeah.
Sorry.
Doctor, yeah. That was wrong.
Okay.
You would have paged this document properly.
Yes, I apologize, Honorable.
Yes. Which one is number one?
Yeah, we're paging it one all the way through.
From the cover page.
Yeah?
From the cover page.
From the cover page.
The cover page is one.
Yeah. It is completely untrue to say that they have complied with the Supreme Court judgment. The history of ALSCON is full of misrepresentation of facts by BPE. BPE gave us, I just want to underscore this, gave us the share purchase agreement. We signed it They sent us a letter, acknowledged it. After that letter of November 22, 2012, we were all ready to conclude the transaction. Then, Onoguruwa was removed sometime in December of that 2012. And Mr. Dickey was then appointed in January. And shortly after that, Mr. Dickey issued a 16-page share purchase agreement to us.
And is that different from the one issued to you earlier?
Completely different. We don't even know where they got it from. So they gave us 16-page. After October, November, December, it's also, it's been numbered now, you know, it's also there. So they send us 16-page, and in this 16-page, they titled it offer to purchase Aluminium Shelter Corporation, a company of Nigeria. So we now told them that you cannot give us an offer now because the Supreme Court have ruled. And you cannot tell us that you are selling us aluminium shelter instead of smelter. If it's a typo, correct it, because this is a high-tensed transaction and we are dealing with international investors. That I was embarrassed to see that go out to the US, and my board of directors looked at it. And they refused to correct it until very late. But that was the same document that they wanted me to sign.
Was it in writing that you replied
then? Yes. Yes. Everything was in writing. It's in there. Yes. So they refused, and we told them, look, you've given us a share purchase agreement. You put the price, $250. Email doesn't lie. You send it to us via email. We receive it. We called you. We demanded for additional information. You supplied us almost 3,000 pages. It wasn't by mistake. And then we looked at the addendum, which included that 3,000 pages, and we responded back to you. And we thought everything was okay. And you sent us a letter saying that even though you are slow, that you received the share purchase agreement as a firm commitment to move forward. Why all of a sudden, in January 29th of the following year, you now come with 16-page document and demand that we must sign that? If we do not sign it, the transaction is null and void. So we now told him, look, we will not sign this.
In writing.
That this is unilateral action and totally in defiance of the Supreme Court judgment, which mandated, ordered, and decreed that you give us a mutually agreed share purchase agreement, which you have offered us.
Which
I have all signed.
You signed, they signed.
Yes. I executed mine. I returned it to them.
So three doctors said that let the status quo be maintained.
Yes.
You have agreed.
Yes.
Government
to cost. Yes. So we signed it, returned it to them, and even in our transmittal letter, is ask them to give us their banking information so that payment will be made. And they refused to do that.
And this is in writing.
It was on the cover of the listing. We also emailed it to them. Email doesn't lie. And that was what Justice Cafferati, in the enforcement of the Supreme Court judgment, said this is the mutually agreed share purchase agreement which the Supreme Court ordered, because both of you have negotiated it.
Okay, so you went for your interpretation of that judgment?
Yes.
The Federal High Court?
Federal High Court.
Interpretation of the Supreme Court agreement?
Yes, and it was, we were ordered, we were directed by the Supreme Court to go for enforcement. The Supreme Court was very angry that the decision has been taken. In fact, they reaffirmed the judgment, said, look, this thing is for enforcement. Go down to the lower court, high court, or appeals court. And they gave our lawyers option, whichever one you want. Go there and enforce it. And the lawyers were senior counsel. So they told the Supreme Court, okay, we're going to the Federal High Court. And this was stated by Chief Wole Olanipeku. And then we went to the Federal High Court. By the way, BPE, in their response at the Supreme Court, asked the court to dismiss the case. And the court was angry. Why do you want us to dismiss the case? I'm saying this because I was in court, and any of the senior counsel will attest to this. Why do you want us to dismiss it? We're sending it for enforcement. And that was how we now choose to go to the Federal High Court. And when we arrived there, BPE never said that judgment doesn't exist. They submitted all their claims. Justice Cafferati, in the enforcement judgment, said, look, the 58-page mutually agreed share purchase agreement, which we now mark as Exhibit F, is the agreement that the Supreme Court ordered, and BPE should sign it. And since we have already signed it the previous year, 2012, and submit to them, that they should sign, so this transaction should move forward. Yes. Yes.
I order that an order is granted directing the respondents to fully enforce and give effect to the meaning and intent of the judgment of the Supreme Court dated 6th of July 2012 by signing and executing forth with the mutually agreed share purchase agreements.
Yes.
Annexed to the applicant's motion as Exhibit A with a purchase price of US$410 million.
Yes.
Was there an order varying this share purchase agreement?
The variant.
That it is hereby further ordered that the respondent should accept 10% of the purchase price or US$41 million to be paid within 15 working days of this enforcement order on 2014. The balance of US$369 million to be paid as per audited financial statement as at the date of this judgment being 30th day of September 2014 to be conducted by KPMG.
That must be the Federal
Supreme Court, sir. Okay, Federal High Court.
Yes. Yes.
Federal High Court.
Yes. The Supreme Court judgment, one point that I would like to bring, very, very important for this Honorable Committee.
Because why I'm asking this question, you said you went for interpretation and enforcement of the judgment of the Supreme Court.
Yes.
And the Federal High Court.
Yes.
And this is what they ordered.
Yes.
They are talking about $410 million.
Yes.
And you are referring to $250 million. Mm-hmm. So there is a conflict. So can you please enlighten us?
Okay. The when we went to the Federal High Court with enforcement of the Supreme Court judgment, and note that the Supreme Court judgment said in accordance with the agreement dated May 28, 2004. No, in accordance, if you read the Order 1. Order 1, yes. Yes. Order 1 says in accordance with the May 20, 2004 agreement. And you see that agreement also attached to the Supreme Court judgment.
Right.
Uh-huh. Now, if you look at that order, at that agreement specified the details that was agreed to by the parties. That agreement also provided for the safety of the assets, that the obligation to protect the asset and to make sure nothing happens to it resides with the BPE. But after 10 years of litigation, when we came back, we saw that the asset that we bid it for $1.3 billion then in 2004.
Sorry, sir, once again.
Yes.
Dated 6th of July 2012.
Yes.
The first order is an order of specific performance is given to key directing defendants respondents to provide the mutually agreed
the bid price of $410 million, that is the sum of $41 million within 15 working days from the date of the execution of the share purchase agreement, in accordance with the agreement dated 20th of May 2004, and the 90% balance of bid price shall be paid within 90 calendar days.
Yes. So the dated May 20th. So it's right behind that judgment.
So the 20th agreement varies
the Supreme Court judgment.
That is, you know, varies the price.
Varies the Supreme Court judgment?
No. It's part of the Supreme Court judgment. He said that the payment of that amount, 410.
Was there a condition precedent to the payment of the 410 million?
Yes.
What was the condition precedent?
The is that it must agree to the agreement of the May 20th that both of us agreed to.
2004. The
yes.
Supreme Court judgment was very clear.
In accordance with
the agreement dated May 20th, 2004.
Yes.
So
this is the agreement.
And the 20th May agreement.
Yes.
Said that you should pay $250 million.
No, he said it gave them section H of that agreement, or I, stated call for the safety of the asset to be maintained by the seller, which is BPE. But when we came back after 10 years, the value of the asset has gone down from $1.3 billion to $100
million. Yes. Doctor, sir, let's help each other.
Yes. When we came back, the BPE, when I asked Onogorowa, how come the asset has dropped from $1.3 billion that when we bought it in 2004 in terms of value, and now the same auditor of KPMG of ALSCON now says the asset is worth less than $100 million. That it was not the intent of the Supreme Court that I should use $410 million to pay for asset of $100 million. So, and our lawyers called the attention of safety of assets, which was agreed to in May in 2004, that it is the obligation of the BPE to ensure that this asset was intact. But now that you have dropped the value to $100 million, which bank, who in his right mind, will give you $410 million to go and pay for something the auditors, which you, BPE, and the Russians engaged, have issued a report consistently over the 10 years, showing a downward drop in value, and now it stands at less than 100 million. And then UBP now is insisting I pay 410. 410 was based subject to or in accordance with the May 20, 2004 agreement, which actually specified that you must make sure that this asset is protected, safeguarded, and ready for us to purchase and pay you 410. And that is the reason why they gave us 250 initially. And we did not care. That was why initially they emailed the SPA and gave us 250.
Better leave this one later, okay?
So we did not care. We said, okay, we want to move in quickly. We want to pay. And we signed the agreement and send it. So when the DG is saying, the Supreme Court said 410, but they miss one important point. This is key in the interpretation of that judgment, because the Supreme Court put it in there for a reason, that in accordance with this agreement, because this is what we agreed prior to bidding for $410 million. Otherwise, the Supreme Court is telling us to take $410 million to go and pay for an audited value property of $100 million. So we brought this to them and said, let us sit down and discuss this. We wrote them a letter. There's nothing that we did with them that we did not put it in writing. We sent them a letter and said, look, we need to sit down and discuss this. But because the Russians have already given them commandment, our request was turned down, blatantly. So when we went back to this the High Court, the High Court looked at it and said, look, you send this SPA to them. And over the months, they ask you for additional information you supplied. And in this case, 3,000 pages documents. There's no mistake here. And they sign and return it to you, and you acknowledged and send this letter back. So why are you bringing a different SPA the next year? That it was just a strategy to frustrate the Supreme Court judgment. That is the facts. There's nothing there at all. We have all sworn to say nothing but the truth. And you can see it also in that order. So I must say, all our submission is here, and we are willing to give the committee additional information. The main reason why I told my members to come is that, one, I feel that the Supreme Court of this country cannot give judgment and someone sits anywhere and begin to think of how to frustrate it. As a citizen of this nation, I personally have a duty, apart from my corporate interest, to make sure that no one rubbish, particularly a foreign company, come in here and then rubbish the decision of the Supreme Court of our nation. BFIG Group have done everything that they've asked us to do. We've given them, cooperate with them, to work with them, do whatever we can to make sure that this property, which is now non-performing, is put back. But rather, what we have seen is that a complete stripping of this asset. And I'm not lying to you, in here too, there is a police report. A police report, I think that's page 116. A police report seizing four 40-foot trailer that obviously took out everything from that land. And we cannot sit here and fail to bring it out to you to know that a lot is going on every day that we watch. These people are destroying that property, cutting them away, and I brought that to the attention of BPE. They said Jaja is playing politics. Here is the police report that says that the Nigerian military arrested 10 people. Nigerian military seized four trucks containing valuables of ALSCON and then handed over to the police. You know, so we are pleading to this committee that you are the final hope of every citizen in this country. I started this effort from the Fifth Assembly, and this assembly also issued an order then, back in 2005. And if I may paraphrase the key point of that order, they declared ASCON transaction by a resolution as well by an order that ALSCON transaction as packaged by BPE and the presidency constitute fraud and corruption against the nation, in quote. And I have a copy here I can make for this House pass that resolution. And since then, I have maintained a very aggressive action to continue to press on and to fight to the best that I can. And it is only you who is representing this nation that can come and see what you can do to protect this transaction, because it's becoming extremely emotional to me that anyone who have looked at this transaction with a fair mind, with a patriotic zeal, will see that BFIG Group is absolutely, absolutely frustrated, cheated, and we have thrown every penny that we got to protect our right and to acquire the asset, turn it around, help our nation, employ our youth, and do all the things that this administration promised this nation. Today, I must say that the Russians inherited more than 720 employees. Today, they have nearly zero employees. They inherited a production plant that is producing. Today, zero production. They inherited a very fine company that mandated that they must dredge the river in order to promote economic growth and development in a region that is so turbulent and sensitive in this country. They refuse to dredge, and they have not returned the 130 million back to this nation. But they are claiming that they own the plant, even though the plant was sold to them for 250 million. And they only paid 130 and promised to dredge the river up to today. And this House have consistently pounded on BPE. Where is the 120 million for the dredging? And if you ask them now, no one would be able to give you a straight answer. And they talked about the bond. We provided a bond that qualified us to bid. That is not an issue any longer. We are talking about what happened at 2004, the injustice. But in the document that I have provided you, you will see on page seven, the BPE, page seven, I believe, reading from the second to the last paragraph. BPE on its own wrote to the vice president and said that even Rosal did not provide their bond, meaning that they were not even qualified to sit and compete with us. This is their document. Page seven. The second to the last paragraph. Page seven, second to the last paragraph, where he says, talking about the UC Rosal, he said, we replied, meaning that they replied Rosal. We replied to ensure that they had enough time to submit their surety security bid bond and financial bid by June 4, 2004. June 4, 2004 was the last day given to all bidders to provide their bond. But by their own statement, by their own report to the president, unfortunately, by close of work on Friday, June 4, 2004, nothing was received from Rosal. And Rosal did not give that bond. This same House uncovered this fact then. So why are we being treated this way? and a foreign company is allowed to get every possible advantage. That share purchase agreement, 58-page share purchase agreement that you've seen, is exactly what UC Rusal signed today, and we are ready to provide this committee with that. It's exactly 58-page document. And Onogurua said to us, ALSCON only have one share purchase agreement. So since the Supreme Court have ruled, we will send you that share purchase agreement. And the reason is because we negotiated this share purchase agreement together with the Russians in terms of the heads of agreement. That is what we have as the May 20th agreement. All the key points were identified, and we sat down, VPE, Rosal, and us, and negotiated. So after we won, then they expanded the agreement in terms of the language. But all the key points were jointly negotiated by all the parties. So we are appealing to this Honorable House, please, bring whatever you can on BPE and the NCB to resolve this matter and to resolve it very quickly. Because we mean well for the region. If we don't mean well, we cannot sacrifice 12 years of our life fighting